You're watching a special broadcast of Reality Check. As the cases surge in India, the focus once again is on Maharashtra. Almost a sense of deja vu as Maharashtra and Mumbai contribute to a bulk of India's current COVID surge, with close to 11,000 daily cases being reported in Maharashtra, the most of any state, 8,000 of those from Mumbai alone. Joining me on the show is IS Chahal, who's the commissioner of the Mumbai Municipal Corporation, the BMC, as to how they plan to fight this latest surge. And Mr. Chahal, thank you so much for joining us. Let me ask you, first of all, is it fair to say, before we get into how you fight the surge, is it fair to say that we're now at the starting point or in the middle of a third wave?
Sir, you are right. We are in the beginning of the third wave, because from 21st December 2021 onwards, our positivity has been in the ascending way all the way without any interruption. Whole of August, September, October, November, our positivity was less than 1%. And for the first time, the positivity in Mumbai went beyond 1% on 21st December. And since then, the climb is steady. And today is day 14, yeah. And we are at positivity of 17.4%. Okay. So it is amply clear that a wave is building up. It's very difficult to predict that at what stage we are. But as in today and yesterday, we got 8,000 cases. Today morning, again, we have 8,000 cases. Although yesterday and today, the cases are same. And
just to understand, it's correct to say that we're in the third wave?
Looks like that.
So now, to understand from you that when we see this huge jump, 8,000 cases a day, towards the end of December, it was almost seven times less. So it's been a huge 7x jump. You are still saying to people not to worry and not to panic, because you're saying that the percentage or the proportion of people who are ending up in hospital and who are ending up on critical oxygen beds is still quite small. Explain that.
I'll answer this question in two parts. First, I'll tell the existing status, and then some comparisons. Number one, since 21st, we have got 29,300 active cases now. And out of this 29,300 cases, almost 2,600 plus are home quarantined. And yesterday, if you see, we got 8,003 cases. And hospitalization was 503 cases, which comes to roughly 4 to 5%. And out of this 503 cases, another comforting factor was there was not a single case which went to ICU, and only 56 cases were on the oxygen beds because of their high comorbidities, as a matter of precaution, not as a matter of requirement. So, as far as this phase is concerned, of the last 14 days, although cases have increased from 100 or 150 to almost 8,000 now, but hospitalization is not more than 5%. And that too, they are going in the normal COVID beds rather than going into oxygenated beds or ICUs. Now, while saying this, I would say that there is no cause for immediate panic, but we have to be very alert, we have to be very guarded, we have to be very careful, we can't be complacent, because the way the virus is growing, it is quite likely the numbers can be humongous.
Right, so even though, as you say, that the percentage may be quite small, that's also because the number of cases overall hasn't exploded. But if you end up with a huge number of daily cases, we're talking about in the range of 10,000-20,000 a day, then that percentage of hospitalizations or the number of hospitalizations is actually going to go up, which is what we saw in the second wave as well. This could cross the second wave. Aren't you worried?
Yeah, but I'll explain. You know, in the second wave, which started in Mumbai from 10th of February and ended on 31st of May, 100 days, in these 100 days, we were getting approximately 78% asymptomatic and 22% symptomatic on average. It would vary between 75 and 80%. The average was 78% on the entire wave. And this 22% people who were symptomatic, everybody was going to hospital bed. and majority of them were directly entering ICU or directly entering oxygenated beds.
Hmm.
We had tremendous stress on oxygenated beds and ICU beds because turnaround time of ICU bed is almost 25-30 days sometimes. People don't get out so fast. Whereas in normal COVID beds, people are out in 5 or 7 days. So this is one difference between that wave, which is more comforting now,
okay,
that instead of all 22% that time symptomatic going to hospital, only 5% or 50% of symptomatic or 10% goes to the hospital bed now.
Right. So, okay. So while you say that the overall occupancy is not very high, when we actually broke down the data put out by the BMC, it actually suggests that oxygen beds are 8% occupied. ICU beds, about 2,700 beds, about 400 are occupied. That's 14%. Ventilator beds of the 1,360, 253 or 20% are occupied. Those are high numbers.
You know, Vasu, we have not put all the beds on the dashboard right now. We will be activating beds in phases. Right now, only 14,000 beds are activated, DCHC and DCH on the dashboard. We have 30,000 of them available with us. For example, we have 4,000 plus ICU, but we are not. It is not activated in the new jumbos and many other hospitals. So we will be activating, going from 14,000 to 30,000 beds as and when the need arises. And that is the reason why these percentages are swimming to 12%, 15% now.
Right, because as I said, 20% or 14% of ventilator or ICU beds being occupied is high.
Yeah, because if you take ICUs from 2,600 to 4,000 plus, then this percentage will drop down.
So, okay, so while you say that you at the moment seem to be managing the number of hospitalizations and all that, the fact is that the virus is surging, the city is still very much out and about. Are you considering strengthening the measures you already have in place, the containment measures? Are you thinking of moving towards a lockdown?
You know, this was debated and discussed in a meeting chaired by Honorable CM Sir on the 30th of December. And the general consensus was that instead of positivity being a benchmark for putting restrictions or putting a harsh kind of a semi-lockdown, the new yardsticks, unlike the first and the second wave of positivity, should be your hospital beds availability, vacancies and people oxygen requirement. These two should be the new benchmarks which should decide on the future restrictions. And if we see in the last 5-6 days, everything cases went from 3,000 to 8,000 in the last 5 days. There's not much stress, added stress on these two factors, the oxygenated beds and the ICU beds. Even before when the wave didn't start, before 21st December, if you see our dashboards, that time also we had about 1,500 beds occupied. Because all MMR people, everybody comes to Mumbai for treatment. So these 3,000 beds which got occupied, only half of them have got occupied in the recent 14 days. So it was decided that we will review these our strategy on a weekly basis. Honorable CM said that we'll again meet around 7th of Jan and then we'll take the things forward. But I have done my own homework that we are very robust system in Mumbai, where we have 186 hospitals, 30,000 beds on a single real-time dashboard of allotment through BMC only. Even if tomorrow we assume that we get 20,000 cases in a day and 5% average continues, so we get about, say, 1,000 people going to beds every day. And luckily, Omicron has a cycle of 5 days. People are getting negative in 5 days' time. Worst to worst, they get negative in 7 days. Even assuming 10-day cycle, even if I get 10,000 beds occupied every day, in 10 days, I occupy 10,000 beds. And then the vacation starts, the cycle starts. And with 20,000 figures also coming every day, with the present kind of hospitalization, Mumbai will not cross beyond 12,000, 13,000 occupied beds, where we have 30,000 beds are there. So that's why I had requested the Honorable CM Sir and our senior officers that oxygenated beds occupancy and the hospital occupancy should be very important factor in deciding further kinds of stringent actions happening. But if we find that things are going out of control, that they go much beyond 20,000, then we have to take a call on that.
So are you saying that if you cross 20,000 cases a day, then you might move towards a lockdown?
No, already we have taken number of steps.
Right. I'll come to all those steps in just a second. But just to clarify, because there's a lot of interest in this and a lot of rumors flying around, you're saying that once you hit 20,000 cases a day, that's when you might consider locking down.
Right now, we believe that even up to 20,000 cases a day, we will be comfortable in our hospitalization and comfortable in our oxygen requirements. These are very dynamic decisions which happen at the spur of the moment, depending on how the scenario is unfolding. But as of now, there should not be any panic at all. Although I always say we have to be very guarded, we can't be complacent, and we can't allow things to go out of control.
Okay, but tell me, sir, why is it that when we see the virus come back, like every time there's a wave, that Maharashtra / Mumbai becomes at the epicenter of it? Because it's come up in the past as well as to whether there's some amount of mismanagement involved.
There are two reasons for that. You know, we have flights coming from all over the world into Mumbai. And we are getting 43 flights per day, right from 27th of November when Government of India alerted us. It's almost more than 35 days now. And out of these 200 odd countries in the world, there are only about 42 countries initially, now 56 which are risk countries. The remaining 100 odd countries are non-risk countries. For the non-risk countries, there is no home quarantine prescription. As per the government of India guidelines, state government guidelines, these people are supposed to just walk away from the airport on landing with negative RT-PCR they're carrying along. And we do only 5% random testing and 90% are not tested. So to assumption that Omicron cannot come from non-risk countries is not true according to me. And although these people who are coming from risk countries, we are keeping very strict watch on them, 5-10 in a day. But these non-risk people, which are almost 5,000 passengers every day, and in the last 35 days, they're almost 200,000 passengers. So they are the major many of them are carriers of the Omicron virus, number one. Number two, Maharashtra is highly urbanized. We have almost 50% population in urban areas, in big cities like Pune, Nagpur, Nasik. And our density of population is very high in these areas. With very high density population, it is quite natural that the virus spreads fast.
Okay, so you say these are the reasons why Mumbai becomes a hotspot every time. Some may debate that, but coming specifically to this current surge, this third wave, would you say that it is largely Omicron which is driving it?
Absolutely. You know, I have been taking input of my experts in the state task force, Dr. Shang Joshi, Dr. Sanjay Oak, Dr. Rahul Pandit. In the morning also, I spoke to them, interacted with them. So their opinion is that that Omicron is now 80%. And Delta is now reduced to 20% from its earlier existence. And this 80% also will touch 90% in the next few days. Maybe it can touch in the next 5-7 days. And otherwise, Delta didn't have a capacity to move from 3,000 to 8,000 in 24 hours. So it is amply clear. In fact, Dr. Shang Joshi, very renowned doctor here, he even told me that it could be 85 to 90% now Omicron presence in Mumbai, which is unlike other cities of India right now, because Mumbai is the first hit it takes when Omicron gets imported from all over the world.
Okay, that's significant. You're saying it could be anywhere in the range of 80 to 90%.
Task force says that 80% has to be, it could be 85 also.
Okay, the implications of that are huge, because if you look at the actual numbers of Omicron in Mumbai detected, it's somewhere in the range of 300 plus.
The genome testing is too a smaller sample as compared to 8,000 cases which are coming up. It is not physically possible to genome these 8,000 cases coming in a day. And whatever small sample we have, that inferences come that only 56% is Omicron, 44 is this. But practically, the way the growth is, it has to be Omicron only.
So tell me, sir, you're saying you don't want to lock down just yet, but what sort of restrictions do you have in place? Because if you look at the numbers, the way they're surging, it's not quite clear whether they're working.
You know, we have taken a number of steps in the last 7 days, although it's not very apparent. Number one, from 5 p.m. to 5 a.m., 12 hours, we have banned assembly of people in all major public places like Gateway of India, Marine Drive, beaches of Mumbai, seven beaches of Mumbai, then Carter Road, all these places, there shall not be any assembly those 12 hours. This we are strictly enforcing. If you go to Gateway of India after 5 p.m., you won't find anybody there, or you won't find anyone in the Marine Drive after 5 p.m. Number two, from today, we have closed all schools of Mumbai from class 1 to class 8, and class 9 to class 12 also, since we have to vaccinate 4.54 lakh students in class 9 to class 12, we can't allow them to sit home and then collect from thousands of places. We say that they will come to school, but only for vaccination. Once they come to school for the next couple of days, buses will take them to our nine COVID jumbo centers and vaccinate them. So that is second step we have taken, that we want to keep children safe. Their online studies will continue, but at least for 31st of January, we are stopped these schools from working physically. Then number three, Maharashtra, we were allowing up to 1,000 people for weddings. We have brought this down to 50 only, 50. Then we were allowing 50% of the occupancy space. We have brought it down to 25% now. For funeral, we have made it 20 people only. Marriages, 50 people only. A number of such action steps have been taken, but drastic steps like shutting down restaurants or shutting down theaters or putting lockdowns, that still, I would disagree with that.
Okay, so no drastic steps, you say. You want to wait till it hits 20,000. But of course, you also have the vaccination drive, which has started. It's 50 to 18 year olds now that have started from today. Do you have enough vaccines both for them, for those who still need their first or second doses, and also now booster shots coming up?
Yeah. We have one of the highest stocks in the country because our 144 private hospitals, they have acted like a great help to me. They are like one of, I would say, this is like a backbone. And Mumbai has about, these private hospitals, they have about 14 lakh vaccine stock with them. BMC has 7 lakh. So we have more than 2 million vaccine available to us. In fact, our second dose is 88% completed today. This 12% remaining, which will make Mumbai fully vaccinated, this we need only about 11 lakh vaccinations. And we have 21 lakh vaccinations with us. But people are not due. Because Covishield, people get due after 84 days. And majority of people, since they are not due for the second dose, that is the only reason why we are away from a fully vaccinated second dose. So Mumbai has done very well. Now for children, Mumbai has 20.8 lakh children in the, between class 1 and class 12, 20.8 lakh, out of which 4.54 lakh are in class, are in age group of 15 to 18, class 9 to class 12. Out of this 4.5 lakh, 37,000 are in BMC schools and 2.17 lakh are in private schools of Mumbai. Today morning, 11 o'clock, we have inaugurated our drive as per Government of India's instructions of vaccination. And we plan to complete first dose of all 37,000 children in BMC schools in the next 4 days. The micro planning is already done. And we plan to do about 9,000 to 10,000 cases a day. And by Thursday, I can assure you that every child in a BMC school will vaccinate. And similar plan now we have drawn for private schools. The children will come to schools and our buses or school buses will bring them to Jumbo, nearest Jumbo hospital, nine of them. Mm-hmm. And we will go whole hog in vaccinating them.
Right, sir. So in conclusion, you appear calm and unruffled as always, but you are confident that, I mean, behind this calm demeanor of yours, you're confident that you have enough hospital beds and oxygen to deal with this potential surge that's coming, the tsunami that's coming. You are confident.
In the last 14 days, if you see the progression of the last 14 days, you can see a check randomly from in Mumbai how situation is. And you know, Srinivasan, we have one of the best home quarantine models in the country. What happens that all these people, like 8,000 yesterday, out of which 7,500 didn't go to hospital, or another thousands of them who landed at Mumbai airport, There's an online system. Either we tap these labs or we tap the Air Suvidha portal, and at 9 a.m. in the morning, our 240 dashboards have their names, addresses, telephone numbers, passport numbers in front of them. And we call them, we start calling these people 5 days in a day for home quarantine from international passengers. We go tell them to come on video calls to check whether they're home or not. Our ambulances go to the society, gives orders in writing to the management that if this guy is seen outside his flat, we'll put a FIR on him and put him to institution quarantine. They need to read into be clicked. Then we our ambulances move randomly and visit these home quarantine passengers to see whether they're home or not. If not found home, they'll be prosecuted. So you can tell you that there's tremendous amount of fear in these people to roam around. Similarly, this 7,500 people who came asymptomatic who were home quarantine, we are calling them 5 times in a day till they become negative. And we rush to their places, develop symptoms with ambulances, and we allot them bed at the residence and put them in the hospital bed. So in this system, but my only worry was these people coming from non-risk countries, where the protocol says that they need to not be home quarantined, they need to be self-monitored only. These guys, they, according to me, have spread this virus, and their number is not that great. So I am pretty sure that with the system in place, we have systems working on autopilot.
Okay.
And our testing is never less than 50,000, all predominantly RT-PCR.
Right.
But at the same time, I feel very worried for other cities like rest of Maharashtra state, where these figures, once they go out of control, then even a 0.5%, 1% mortality can become a huge number.
Right.
That is why we have to be very guarded, very careful, and very cautious. We cannot be complacent. In Mumbai, if you see, day for yesterday, we had zero death. Yesterday, 3 days back, we had zero death. 2 days back, we had one death. Yesterday, again, we had zero death. So we are, the last 14 days, our death is between 0 and 2 only per day. So
Right. These
indications do give you comfort level.
Thank you very much indeed, Chahal sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.